just gonna be me out here today, guys. All right, well, let's get this pack strapped on and let's go ahead and hit the trail. All right, guys, well, I've been hiking for a little while and I think we might have found the spillway. I'm not sure. Like I said, I didn't bring a map. I got one of this place, but I didn't bring it, so not sure. The trail seems to go on up around that way. So I'm not entirely sure if this is supposed to be the end of where we're supposed to be, but I don't know, guys. Trail keeps going, so let's go on around. Let's see. Give you guys a shot of this. Let me see if I can zoom in for you guys. I brought my new steady stick today, so you guys see that boathouse way over there? If it'll focus on it, that's where we started. That's all the way across the lake. That was the actual parking lot we come through. So yeah, we've walked a ways, guys. The old stick's holding up pretty good. Seems to be working pretty good. Let's go on around. Like I said, I know there's supposed to be an area, what they call the spillway area. That would seem kind of close to me. Not exactly sure. Check out those rocks down there, guys. This has been an awesome little hike, I'll be honest with you. The first time I came, like I said, I left my card in the computer, so I didn't even bother hiking that day. I did go over to a couple of little places and took some pictures, but look at that, guys. It's awesome. But like I was saying, I did take a few pictures, but I didn't go on a hike because I didn't really have any way to document it. And I can be honest with you, I don't know where this trail actually leads. I don't know if this is part of the trail or part of what somebody else has created over time, but there's the water down there again. There's a bird way over there on the bank. I don't know if you can see him. There he is. He's down here enjoying coolness. It is a little bit cooler down here. Than it is anywhere else. I'm seeing a good bit of activity down there in that water, guys. I'm not sure what that is. Oh, those are fish, guys. They're actually fish in there, right down in that water, which is honestly funny, because there's really nowhere else for them to go, to be honest. Let's go back up this way. The trail kind of forks off here. I'm thinking that's probably going to be it. I see a little small trail that cuts through there, but it's real thick back in there. So maybe this is it. Maybe we did find the spillway part of it. I really want to get down here and get you guys a shot of those fish. I don't know if you can see them or not. Let me see if I can get them zoomed in here for you. See them down there? Well, if it would focus, you guys could see. Alright, I'll tell you what, guys. Let me try to get down to the bottom of this and I'll see if I can get you guys a little closer. Alright, guys, yeah, I just scouted up ahead just a little bit and we're to the end of the trail, which I knew the trail looped around and come back around. I did get down that. Doesn't look that bad on camera, but it is. The water's so murky, I really don't know if you guys can see them or not. They kind of all took off when I got down here, but you guys can see up through there. That actually forms a waterfall when the water's up, but as most of you can imagine now, we're kind of in a drought like most places are, so won't be any water coming down through there today. But yeah, this is it, guys. We made it to the end of the trail. We did pretty good, made pretty good time, honestly. Right now it's about 11:30. So we made pretty good time. All right, well, let me cut you guys off. Let me climb back up this hill. I don't want you guys to see me bust my tail on that. And then we'll get up here to the spillway and we'll take us a break for a few minutes. We'll go over some of this gear that I got today. All right, guys. All right, guys. Well, we made it back to the spillway. And we're going to sit here and we're going to take us 5 or 10. And just see what's going on. Those butterflies are awesome. Just sitting there getting water. They've been there the whole time. I mean, I've walked around them the whole thing. They're just content as they can be. Sopping up some water. Might have went in just a little too far on that guy. There we go. But yeah, like I said, guys, we're back at the spillway now, and we're gonna take this little bit of a break. And like I said, once we get done with that, or once I get done with that, I say we because it's, you know, me and you guys. So we're gonna take us a little break right now, and then we'll go over the we'll go over some of the gear that I brought out today. Like I said, first thing I showed you guys was the my new EDC bag, which is the SOG Ninja Day Pack. It's a pretty good bag. I like it. I was toting just like a small haversack. In all honesty, I'm glad that's not what I brought today. But yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna take a few minutes for a break and everything, and then once I end up getting some water and taking just a few minutes, we'll go over this pack and I'll show you the new knife and everything. So stay with me, guys. Whole lot more to come. We still got to hike this trail back. But guys, this has been way past due here. I've been meaning to get back out here and shoot this video for you guys on this trail. Like I said, trails are pretty wide. It's a good hiking trail to go down. Honestly, I really don't know how long it is. I'll have to look it up once I get back and find out exactly how long it is, but it's a good little day hike. And as you can see right there, there's a trail. Somebody made the cut through to actually come around on the other side. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna hike the whole thing. For the most part, the whole path is almost shaded, the whole trail for that part. I mean, there's a couple of little parts that's kind of out in the sun or whatever, but for the most part, it's pretty awesome. Check that out. Huh. Interesting. But yeah, again, I do apologize to you guys for it taking so long getting out here, but we're here now, so that's the main thing. There's a lot of cedar and pine. I have saw a few white oaks out here as well. Most of the pines in here are pretty good sized trees, honestly. And then when you start looking at it, a good bit of the cedar has actually either been knocked down or has actually fell down. I can imagine this little area right here probably floods. Little area here is a little swampy. I hope you guys are enjoying this, because I sure am. I kind of wish my wife would have been able to come, but you know, she's working and everything. So I know she likes to get out and hit a lot of these trails with me. honestly, I wish our kids were a little bit more into it. But you know, what can you do? Keyword being teenagers on that. So this is an example of what I was talking about. That there, that's a cedar. There's a cedar right there. It's also done fail. Everywhere in here, there seems to be cedar that's fallen. And this place does offer camping. Not sure. I know for a fact they've got the, RV parking, because I ran into that. Oh, you guys, come here and check this out. Just happened to see this guy. Look at that guy. I don't know if you guys are getting him or not, but I don't want to interrupt him. Pretty good sized spider. Alright guys, well, I'm not sure how far we are from the trailhead, but we've hiked back in here pretty good ways. Pretty sure it's not far from here. Matter of fact, I'm pretty sure of it, that we're real close to the trailhead here. Yep, we're getting real close. We're almost at the boathouse now. Like I said, guys, this has been a pretty awesome little hike. You can see out across there. And all the way over there, where those two guys are, whatever that is on the pier over there. We were way over there. Honestly, I was trying to zoom in and I'll show you guys where we were at. We were way over back in there, if it'll focus. That's where we were at. So, stupid focus. And we had to come all the way back around, followed all the way back around, and to right here where we're at now. Like I said, this has been an awesome little hike. It's been well overdue. Been needing to get out and do a little hiking and just get out of the house, really. Walk out here. Like I said, this is a nice little place. I mean, it is a state park, so they do charge an entry fee to get in, but other than that, it's a pretty awesome place. $2, I mean, you know, and this is, I'll tell you, give you a little insight here. Pretty sure you can rent these boats. Hadn't really checked into that, but pretty awesome little get up they got here. Boat rentals from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Boats must be rented by the park ranger or campground host. Rental fees are $10 half a day. One life jacket per person is required to be in the boat. Anyone under the age of 16 is required to wear a life jacket. Jackets and paddle are available at the time of rental if needed. Pretty awesome, pretty awesome. Some of these boats have got a good bit of water in them, but other than that, I think you can rent those, or you can rent these canoes over here. I parked up in the upper parking lot up there. If I knew it, I could have parked right in there, but I didn't. And like I said, it's no big deal. Just added to the hike, and you know, nice little boat landing. You can also see some fish down in there too, little small ones. I don't know if you guys can see them, but zooming in on them right now wouldn't do you guys much good. All right, well, we're gonna walk back up this way. I'll take you over here and we'll check these canoes out. These canoe racks kind of remind me of a Friday the 13th movie. However bad that is. I know on up the lake up there, there were actually some ducks. As you can see, what I was telling you guys earlier, Ducks Unlimited Wood Duck Box Conservation Project. So, well, I think we're gonna go over here and take us about a 5 minute break and see who that was texting, and then I'll head up and I'll show you guys the big bridge up here. Alright guys, as you can see, I don't have my pack on. I made it back to the truck and I drove down to the lower end down here, and I'm wanting to show you guys this awesome bridge that they got down here. I also see a looks like a crane or something on the bridge down here. Might be able to get a shot of him if we can sneak up on him real quick. Looks like he might be getting ready to take flight here in just a minute. Let me see if I can get us a little bit closer to him. All right, let me turn you guys around. There's the bridge. Now let's see if we can get him. Well, might be better if I let the stick down a little bit, might not. Sorry about that, guys. Let's see now, where is he? Right there. About as good as I can zoom in on him, boys. but he is a good ways out. And as you can see, I mean, it's a nice place. You got your bathrooms and the truck back there, and you got the areas to cook or whatever, playground for kids. You also got these nice benches and stuff sitting over here. There's also another bench right there. There's one. We'll go up on here. Trying to be real quiet, guys. I want to try to get as close to this guy as I can get it. He's probably going to take off on us, though. Look out across there. And you got this side. And see, this is on the other side of where we were. There he goes, guys. This camera would focus. Well, I kind of done away with that. Like this middle. The only thing I wish they had did was actually come out here and built. Excuse me, goose. I wish they would have put like a top on this and actually put some seating out here like they did up there on, over on the banks and everything. But you know, the last time I was up here, if I'm not mistaken, I'm not gonna go too far because I didn't lock the truck up. And I left the windows down and my packs in there. So yeah, not gonna go too far. I think the last time I was up here, and I think when I went across, I think there was a sign up that said that the trail hadn't been completed. I'm pretty sure there's a hiking trail on this side too. They may have finished it since I was here the last time. I'm not real sure. I don't really see the sign now. I think that sign was on this tree right over in here. So they may have completed it. Look at this. Somebody done got hung up more than a couple times on that particular tree there. I know I count at least, there's a worm and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 corks in that one more, in that one tree. Man. Oh yeah, here it is. Now they've actually moved it. I can still see the truck, so we're good. No trail access. There's no designated trail on this side of the lake at this time. The area is still under construction, so the park staff ask you to use caution. Which pretty much means there's man-made trails. If you want to do it, go ahead. But like I said, I didn't lock the truck up, so I didn't necessarily plan to go back out or anything. So all right, guys, well, we're gonna head on back across this bridge. I know you guys don't want to walk, hey
guys,
across.
Welcome there. Back at the picnic area. I hope you guys really enjoyed the hike today and the look around Chester State Park. I know I've enjoyed it. When I was parking the truck a while ago, you guys check out what I found. Pine pitch. There's probably a whole lot more over there. I'm probably gonna go over there and check out some more of it before I go back. But as I promised you, I want to go ahead and kind of show you guys what I brought with me today. Of course, I brought my camera. I brought my, I call steady stick. A lot of people call it different things. The Voodoo Tactical Ninja Pack is the correct name for it, I guess is what they say. Let me cut this music off or we get in trouble for that. Alright, sorry about that. But yeah, this is the pack. My wife bought it for me a little while back. It's like I said, it's a good pack. I like it. I don't know, I don't think I really want to do a review on this pack now, but I can tell you that it's got a pocket here, here. One on the inside, there's one on the back side for billfolds and cell phones, what have you. Molly webbing down both sides, water bottle holder. This one does have the setup for the water bladder, and your outlets are up here on each side, whichever side you want to take it out on. So that's what I brought with me today, was the SOG Ninja Day Pack. Also brought this with me. This is the knife I've been working on. This is the Condor Bush Lore. I picked it up in Tennessee while I was there. Been lead seating the handle and everything, and just used an older sheath that I had. Worked out pretty good today. I really didn't have to use it a whole lot, but you know, I brought it anyway. I just wanted to take it for its first day out to see how it would do, and done pretty good, so. Of course, I'll do some more videos up on these pretty soon, but that's pretty much what I took, plus the clean canteen. I just now filled it back up, so. But like I said, guys, if I know a lot of you's not from around this part, but if any of you guys are from up in this area, I suggest maybe coming by and actually just take a day to come up here and just hang out. I mean, it's an awesome place. Like I said, across the bridge right over here that we just came off of, there is another trail. It hadn't been built by the Parks Commission, but there is a trail over there if you actually wanted to go. So I think if I go down that trail, I think I'll have somebody else with me. But I hope you guys enjoyed the hike today. I really enjoyed it. And check back with me, and we'll be doing something else here at the Lifestyles of the Southern Highlifer. Thanks, guys. Take care of one another out there.